Good afternoon. What an honor to stand here and represent over approximately 350 colleagues, members of the Reconstructionist Rabbinical Association, many of whom are here today to celebrate this wonderful occasion. I promise you, when I say that it says in my notes, Rabbi, Dr. President, Waxman, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov. The Talmud in the tractate called Brachot describes the blessing that we are to say upon seeing a great scholar of Judaism. Baruch shechalak mechochmato lere'av. Blessed is God who shares from her wisdom with those who revere her. Three words, chalak, chochma, yirah. I believe these are not only timeless words for our tradition in general, but words that can capture what our movement is about and words that can capture what Deborah's leadership has already been about. Chalak, sharing, dividing. It's about interconnectedness. It's about democratizing. It's about community. No one has a monopoly on Torah. No one has a monopoly on truth. Sometimes we quip about the stereotypical Reconstructionist rabbi who facilitates, and wait, what about leading, and how do we define that? And I think these are great, real questions that we have, how to create that balance. And Deborah, when I think about these questions like power over versus power for or power to, I think that you and your values and your style of leadership really embody the best of that word, chalak. Mechochmato, chochma, wisdom. After passing through the days of awe, we hear over and over again in our prayers about God is compassionate, God is forgiving. But there's a blessing that we say each day in the Amidah that reminds us of the blessing of wisdom, the attribute of divine wisdom. If you look at a Hasidic prayer book, you'll see that word chokhmah in the fourth blessing of the Amidah, and it's joined together with other words, bina, da'at, seichel, wisdom, understanding, knowledge, common sense. There are lots of words for the same category of ways that we understand knowledge. The wisdom in leadership is not simply a science. It's not simply something that we write in our theses or read in an academic paper in a study, but it's also an art. And I think when we combine these different words for wisdom, we can appreciate the many ways in which your vision is one that combines all the different types of wisdom together. Lire'av, yirah, awe. It's a great word. The same ambiguity that exists in English with awful and awesome connected to that word yirah has existed in Hebrew for a long time as well. But let's just get back to the awe. Today is awesome. There's a lot that is awesome in the world. And sometimes at those moments of trepidation, whether we're reading the Pew study or just being stereotypically neurotic, as sometimes Jews are, sometimes we feel like we have a lot to worry about, and yet maybe coupled with that worry is that wonderful sense of wonder, that we don't necessarily have all the answers, that not everything is precisely clear-cut. If you've heard that, the proverbial story of the person who walks around with a note in one pocket that says, the world was created for my sake alone, and in the other pocket that says, from dust and ashes I came, and to dust and ashes I will return. I think it's the awe that reminds us of the second pocket, that there is something beyond us, that the world was not just created for our sake. We hear even in Lecha Dodi, Sof Ma'aseh B'machshava Tchila, in our hymn welcoming Shabbat, that Shabbat was the last thing created, but the first in mind, reminding us that we don't have all the answers, that there is always something beyond us. And I think that sense of modesty, that sense of wonder, that can lead to a depth of holiness and a sense of why we do social justice in the world is so important and something that you embody so well. together these three words in a lot of ways. Shechalak, Mechochmato le'Re'av, also are connected to some other famous, more modern Reconstructionist words, I think belonging and behaving and believing in a way. Chalak, we all have a piece of this, we all belong. Chokhmah, there's a way in which our thoughts and which that wisdom really leads to action and behavior. And Yirah, that sense of what we believe, why we're here, not just ourselves, not just mini communities, but beyond us. Deborah, on behalf of all of our colleagues, I am so thrilled to celebrate this public occasion, this official welcoming of you into this office. I am thrilled about our partnership and all that is yet to come, and wish you great hatzlacha. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech haolam, shechalak michochmato l're'av. Amen.